Page six now, the coronavirus and the possible postponement of the Summer Olympics in Tokyo. President Trump is suggesting pushing the date for the Games, but Tokyo is pushing back. The 2020 Summer Olympics are set to begin in July. Hopefully this whole thing burns itself out by then. As of now, the CDC, however, is urging Americans to avoid non-essential travel to China and South Korea. But with Japan's proximity to those areas, it may just be a matter of time before it makes the list as well. Now, joining me now is the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, what do you make of the world's reaction to the coronavirus?
Maybe the better question.
I'm sure there's a better question out there.
Reaction to the coronavirus, right? There are more people are dying from every other cause of death on planet Earth than the current version of the 19th coronavirus that's out there. I'm more concerned about the economic disruption than the numbers of people afflicted. It's much worse economically than it is medically at this point.
Well, you're, of course, no death is obviously something we want. Let's just, you know, stipulate that. But it is taking a huge economic chunk out of the height of every American, especially middle class people who are worried about it. I mean, definitely. And I obviously think that's why the president has put forward all these plans to make sure people are made whole as they can possibly be made. But let me ask you this. There's a psyops going on here. And I know you're all about these kinds of things. China is sending out a psyops operation on Twitter in which it claims the coronavirus was caused by U.S. armed forces and actually started in America and brought to China. So, Barry, I know that you keep track of these kind of wild conspiracy theories that go out, and there's a psyops being run by China government officials on Twitter, as a matter of fact, in which we find out that they think, or they're saying, that coronavirus was started by the U.S. Army. What do you make of that?
It's really cute because it's the exact same story that Iran is putting out, but they're changing the villain. In the Iranian case, it's not the United States Germ Warfare Department of the U.S. Army. It's the Mossad trying to kill all the Muslims in Iran. It just depends on who's putting out the story as to who they're deflecting against, when in reality, the two worst countries infected on planet Earth are China, where it originated, and Iran, where they ignored it for 2 months, and they have probably several hundred thousand people infected. Ironically, the Ayatollah has just announced that even though the coronavirus was created by Jews to kill Muslims, the word is out of Israel now that Israel has a vaccine, it's in testing, and there's a special dispensation if you are a radical Shia that you will be allowed in this one case to accept a Jewish vaccine so you will live another day so you can survive to kill Jews in the future. Isn't it wonderful how propaganda machines of these dictatorial theocracies control their people with a false narrative?
That is shocking. I mean, it's as shocking and not surprising. I should say, it's not surprising. Who am I kidding? I keep track of these guys. It's just, it really is stunning. So Italy is shut down. Israel, we had to cancel a church trip to Israel, as a matter of fact, because you had to be quarantined and they won't let you in unless you've done a quarantine. So the reaction there in the Middle East and in Italy and elsewhere, your impressions?
Well, of all the countries in the world, I don't believe there's a response more aggressive and more pervasive throughout the country than what Israel's doing. They have like 140 cases in a country of nearly 9 million, so it's infinitesimal, and yet the entire country economically is shut down. Everybody has been asked to leave that's not an Israeli. Anybody that comes in goes to quarantine if they're an Israeli citizen. And if you're not an Israeli citizen, you can't come to Israel unless you're going straight into quarantine for 2 weeks and can prove it. Two of my kids have been in quarantine for 2 weeks. It's very tough. The country is being devastated economically by the very aggressive response. And if there's a country in the Western world that's going to stamp this out first based on their response, it's going to be Israel. Yeah. At what cost? It's a catastrophe to their economy, clearly. The good news is Bibi Netanyahu and Benny Gantz, the two people running for prime minister that yes. really don't like each other, are now in serious talks to have a coalition government, well, to have a unified front against Corona.
Finally.
And if that comes out of this, at least the Israelis found some good news.
Absolutely, Barry. Thanks so much.